High-resolution surface reconstruction from overlapping multiple views by Nader Salman and Maria Tevinek from the Geometrica team project in INRIA. Three-dimensional reconstruction of real-world scenes from sequences of overlapping images is a topic of much interest in computer vision, computer graphics, and computational geometry. Its application areas range from preservation of historical heritage to virtual reality walkthroughs, through computer animation, movie production, and e-commerce. The challenge is to recover simplicial models of complex scenes from a set of images taken from various viewpoints around the scene. The models sought after are either surface meshes or 3D meshes of objects in the scene. The first step of the process consists of using a stereo algorithm to extract a set of 3D points from the images. To speed up the extraction phase, the GiroViz project produces sequences of located images describing for each image the position of the camera as well as the shooting parameters. Most match-moving softwares require highly coherent image sequences and generate sparse point clouds. The software of an PCCSTP we use requires located frames and generates quasi-dense point clouds. In both cases, the output of the image processing step is a set of tracks, where each track is a 3D point associated to a list of images where the point is visible. The set of images and tracks constitute the input of our reconstruction algorithm. Now, the extracted tracks are not perfect. They include redundancies, outliers, and noise. First, some multiple tracks correspond to the same 3D feature point and must be merged. As tracks are coming from characteristic points detected in the images, their 3D location should be densely spread over the surface of the objects in the scene. Thus, we detect outliers by computing the average square distance to the k nearest neighbors for each track. Another criterion is based upon the camera positions. For each track P, we compute the smallest cone with apex at P that contains all cameras that observed point P. Tracks with small aperture cone angles are discarded. The final pre-processing step is straightforward, as it smooths the remaining tracks using a jet fitting and reprojection algorithm. At this stage, the goal is to extract from the pre-processed tracks and the input images a set of higher-level primitives conforming to the surface of the objects in the scene. The final reconstruction sought after must respect the sharp creases of the scene. To detect those edges, we perform into the input images a simple contour extraction algorithm based on Frey-Chen edge convolution masks. We will use the detected contours to create in each image a constrained Delaunay triangulation. Let us first define the constraints. In each image, we consider the projection of the tracks observed in this image and perform a classification of these tracks depending on their proximity to the extracted contours. We now consider the complete graph over all the contour tracks and select the edges of this graph which lay over the detected contours. At this stage, the selected edges may not form a correct input for a constrained 2D triangulation. To avoid collinear segments, when two selected edges form a small angle, we eliminate the longest one. Now, to avoid intersections, when two selected edges intersect, we eliminate the longest one. The remaining edges are used as input segments to a 2D constrained Delaunay triangulation, with all projected tracks as vertices. The triangles of this triangulation are then lifted in 3D space using the 3D coordinates computed by the stereo algorithm. This process is repeated for each image, and the output is a 3D triangle soup in which the vast majority of the triangles correspond to the actual surface regions in the scene. However, at occlusion boundaries, the present scheme may produce triangles which connect foreground to background surfaces. Two filtering steps are applied to enforce visibility consistency and to remove erroneous triangles. First, if a triangle belongs to the final surface, then it should not be intersected by any side segment joining a track 3D position to one of the cameras observing this track. This is called visibility constraint. We now filter the big triangles where the longest edge is more than a given fraction of the bounding box. Among these triangles, we distinguish anamorphic and well-shaped triangles. Anamorphic triangles are likely to lie in free space and should be discarded, whereas well-shaped big triangles may or not lie on the surface of the scene and are classified by measuring the cross-correlation between images where they have been seen. Finally, we generate the final scene surface by computing the Delaunay triangulation of the tracks restricted to the triangle soup, and this is what we get on a small sparse point cloud. Delaunay refinement can be used. This is an example on an outdoor scene using Voodoo Camera Tracker. And this is another example on outdoor scene using Certis CSTB software on a quasi-dense point sample. Thank you for your attention.